Good evening. My name is Melanie Alston Balaputra, Vice Principal of Bergen County Technical High School Paramus Campus, and I will be the head of ceremonies for this evening's event. Graduates, please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor and privilege to present to you the class of 2023. Before we begin, I would like to ask that everyone take a moment to silence their cell phones and to refrain from using any noisemakers. Thank you. Exceptional teachers create exceptional students. It is my distinct honor to welcome the exceptional faculty of our Paramus campus. Let's give our faculty and staff another round of applause. At this time, I would like to invite our salutatorian, David Longacre, and our superintendent, Dr. Howard Lerner, to lead us in the pledge to our nation's flag. Please rise and remain standing for our national anthem.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Ariana Jackson will now lead us in singing our national anthem.
Stripes and white stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and rocket red glare, the bones bursting.
Thank you, Ariana. That was truly beautiful. Will everyone please be seated? I'd like to take this moment to recognize some dignitaries that are here with us this evening. Board President William Connolly. And Bergen County Commissioner Chairman Thomas J. Sullivan, who'd like to say a few words.
Thank you. Good evening to the class of 2023. First and foremost, congratulations on reaching this important milestone in your lives. You have worked hard to get here, and you should be proud of yourselves. I'm proud of you, and so is the entire Bergen County community. Now let's talk about the elephant in the room, the COVID-19 pandemic. You were just freshmen when it hit, and you were forced to do your work remotely. I know it wasn't easy, but you all found a way. You made it through, you adapted to this new way of learning, and you thrived. You didn't let a virus stop you from achieving your goals, and that is something to be proud of. And speaking of achievements and your goals, let's talk about the Bergen County School District. I have to say that I am so proud of the work that our county has done in the education sector, especially being that I am the husband of a father and daughter to teachers. We have some of the best schools in the state, especially career-based schools, and that's because of the hard work and dedication of your teachers, administrators, and most of all, you, the students. You're a shining example of what makes our district, our county, and our country so great. So as you move to the next chapter in your lives, whatever that may be, remember that you are capable of anything. You have already proven that by overcoming this unforeseen and unprecedented challenges of the past few years that the past few years have thrown at you. I encourage you to keep learning and growing. Keep pushing yourselves, keep working hard, and keep making us proud. The skills and knowledge you have gained here will serve you well in whatever field you have decided or will decide to enter. But please remember one thing. On your journey, do not ever forget where you came from. Do not ever forget where you came from on the way to where you're going. Because what you have done today has molded you into the people that you're going to become. And just remember the people that helped you, they may need your people, other people are going to need your help in the future. So please be true to yourselves, be true to your teachers, be true to your parents and guardians. And I want to congratulate the class of 2023.
Thank you, Commissioner Chairman Sullivan. I would also like to acknowledge our superintendent, Dr. Howard Lerner, our assistant superintendent, Andrea Sheridan, our assistant superintendent of curriculum and instruction, Richard Panicucci, district supervisors, Bonnie Oberkovich, Jasmine Alventine Valentin, and Bridget Sorum. Principal Jeremy Wertheim. And Campus Supervisor Chris Capodes. All of whom have contributed so much to the success of our graduates. Please join me in celebrating the class of 2023. It's my pleasure to invite our principal, Mr. Jeremy Wertheim, to the podium to address the graduates.
It's my honor to deliver this address before the graduates of the class of 2020, their loved ones, and the exceptional faculty that are here with us this evening. I'd also like to thank Dr. Lerner, Ms. Sheridan, Mr. Panicucci and Mr. Cicino, Without their unwavering support, the Bergen County Technical School District would not produce such extraordinary students. I'd also like to thank County Executive James Tedesco and the County Commissioners for their continued faith and support in our school district. But most of all, I'd like to thank the families of our graduates. You've supported them through thick and thin, ushered them to our amazing district, and worked collaboratively with us to help them meet their potential. One last thing, I'd like to acknowledge one of our staff members here tonight, our beloved automotive collision repair instructor, Joe Pantano. Joe has decided to retire after many decades of training some of the finest auto technicians in the state. Good luck in the future, Joe. (Clears throat) 2023 will probably be remembered as the year that artificial intelligence was really born. And unless you've been living without internet service or under a rock, you know that earlier this year, multiple tech companies released their artificial intelligence programs for the public to use. Artificial intelligence was once something that we thought would come in the future. The theme was woven into Hollywood movies and sci-fi novels, but that future is now. The most prominent AI is ChatGPT, which, as it happens, I used to write the speech. But AI can be used for so much more than plagiarizing graduation speeches. Every graduate here today will be able to harness the power of AI as they create the futures of their trade. It will provide predictive maintenance data to future auto technicians, personalized style recommendations for cosmetology and skincare clients, and generate recipes for those that are entering the culinary arts profession. Quite frankly, the possibilities are frightening. One of the questions I asked ChatGPT as I prepared for the speech was whether the machines would come for all of our jobs. There was good news. The short answer was no. There will still be plenty of work. But the AI offered some talents that our grads should focus on that will be irreplaceable. At the top of the list were creativity, empathy, and compassion. I was proud as a principal as I thought of all the ways Bergen Tech has encouraged our students to grow these skills. Even last week, as I walked down the halls, I saw original student artwork and innovative technical projects. They were obvious symbols of student creativity. They were signs that given the opportunity and the freedom to be inventive, that our students, they can thrive. Over the past few years, I've also seen this group of students support each other through the most difficult times at Bergen Tech. They showed kindness, acceptance, validated each other's challenges, and offered their peers assistance. Their empathy and compassion was not limited to their peers, though. Every student here had the opportunity to help members of the greater Bergen County community. Some built community gardens, others provided food, health, and care services, allowing the downtrodden to feel like humans. Graduates, continue to put these skills to use as you take the next step on your journey in life. I have a few other pieces of advice for you. As your world becomes increasingly complex and your lives become overfilled with responsibilities, make sure to take care of yourselves. Practice the type of empathy and compassion for yourself that you've provided for so many others over all these years. That means making sure that you're meeting your own physical and emotional health needs. You should also stay at the forefront of your trade. Be lifelong learners in your field and maintain relationships with a network of professionals who are going to do the same thing. Lastly, be prepared to embrace change. We live in a world that is ever more dynamic. Change is more inevitable than ever, and being ready to adapt will allow you to roll with the constantly evolving landscape in your life. On a personal note, I really like this class, and I'm really going to miss them dearly. Good luck, class of 2023. I'll miss you a lot.
Thank you, Mr. Wertheim. And now we will have the presentation of the class gift. Ella Suleiman, Kevin Shepherd, and Natalia Kazalka, please come forward at this time.
Good afternoon, parents, fellow graduates, and faculty members. The famous artist Pablo Picasso once said, "Painting is just another way of keeping a diary." And here at Bergen Tech, we do just that. Every year, there has been a tradition where the senior class gives a painting that represents and illustrates our lives as students here at Bergen Tech for future generations to look back on. Our class diary, if you will. It is a privilege and an honor to stand here and acknowledge and thank all of those who have been involved in the collaboration of the mural that we will unveil today. Kevin Shepherd and I collaborated and came up with the inspiration and design of this year's painting, and we are delighted to be able to see the planning, discussions, and design in this mural showcased for all to admire. As we unveil the 2023 class gift, I would like to give credit where credit is due. There is always someone who leads and oversees important projects, someone who is passionate, dedicated, and driven, someone who freely gives their time to an already busy life to ensure projects are completed to a high standard, someone who coordinates, supports, and empowers their students to do their best. It is my pleasure to express my gratitude and thanks on behalf of our student body to our incredible art teacher, Ms. Wilson. For all the work you have done to ensure that we are here today to celebrate the outcome of a rewarding project. So thank you. Really, thank you. I would like to now ask Kevin Shepherd and Natalia Kozalka to unveil the mural.
Thank you to the class of 2023 for your thoughtful gift. We will all think of you whenever we admire this painting. Please welcome our senior class valedictorian, Yahav Pecker, who will deliver the keynote address.
Good evening, SUNY graduates, families, friends, staff, and administration. My name is Yahav Pekel, the valedictorian of the senior class of 2023. We're literally minutes away from walking out of the gymnasium as graduates. Even though we knew it would happen, we really didn't expect it to be that soon. We're like a one big family that's saying goodbye to one another, and we may not see each other again. But to make things less upsetting, let's begin with a quick recap. Freshman year, we came in completely terrified. We didn't know what to really expect from anyone, as we all were new. We all had a trip going up to Connecticut in Club Getaway, where we were supposed to meet our future friends. We had also a Chocolate Trade Tuesday, which was the last day before the day was actually shockingly interrupted by the news of the coronavirus. When we all went back home, we all thought we were going to see each other again in 2 weeks, but we knew that's not going to happen. We really missed each other. It was a really tough time. We missed our friends, we missed our teachers, and we missed just walking in the building. Sophomore year, we continued our remote learning. We came back to school only after really New Year's, but some of us did hybrid and also remote, which was a little bit difficult because we all had our masks up and we really didn't remember each other's faces. That year really felt like Groundhog's Day. It felt like it was more difficult to do really anything. Procrastination is where it really started. During junior year, we came back to school normally, finally, after 2 tough years, but there were still restrictions in place. It was really interesting. They were later lifted in the year, and we were able to sit with our friends again at lunch, in clubs, generally in the classroom, and we also had sports back. But all of a sudden, on March 17th, 2022, Mr. Meany passed away. He meant the world to us. It was a shocking death, and unfortunately, he's not here with us. The day after that, the school had felt very empty. Students and teachers were crying. We had a hole in our hearts, and we continued to think about him each and every single day throughout our time in high school. Finally, in senior year, the year we were all waiting for, it was very, very uplifting. even though we were fully infected now with the senioritis, and I really hope you guys know what that means at this point. Procrastination was really one of the biggest obstacles. It felt more normal. It really felt more normal with the difficulties. We finally had a holiday special, Winter Wonderland, which gave us a feeling of finally having a normal high school experience. An ordinary prom, which felt like a complete blessing. We went to Six Flags too, which felt incredibly special. We really, really had an unordinary high school experience, and we went through it. We really survived high school. Let me be honest right now. It feels like we're just going on a summer break, and we're going to see each other again in the fall. We did not have a typical high school experience, as I mentioned before, but at least we felt it in every emotion possible throughout our time here. I want to thank our administration and teachers for suffering through our senioritis, complaints, and procrastination every single day. But in all seriousness, I really want to thank you for that. I'd also like to thank our friends who had us and had our backs and accepted for who we are with our disabilities throughout our years in high school. But most importantly, our families, our siblings, and our parents. I really want to thank you for everything you've done, because without you guys, we wouldn't have been here. Now to my classmates. Let's use all these memories to our advantage and recognize that our unique high school experience made us individuals we have grown into today. Again, congratulations to the class of 2023. Good luck. Thank you and good night.
We are now ready to present the diplomas to our graduates. Principal Jeremy Wertheim and Board President Mr. William Connolly, will you please come to the podium to certify the diplomas?
Mr. Connolly would like to say a few thank yous before we continue with the certification process. Thank you.
Good evening. I would like to give special thanks to Commissioner Chair Tom Sullivan for being with us tonight. As a board member for many years, I can tell you how important it is to have their support to us, to the whole school district, and to the county. I'd like to thank County Executive Jim Tedesco, Dr. Lerner, and all the executive staff, and of course, to what I consider the best teachers in the state of New Jersey. Thank you very much. And to the parents, thank you all for helping your children get to where they are today. And to the students, congratulations. It is a journey. You've accomplished a tremendous amount. There's so much ahead of you. Take it, run with it, and do what you know how to do best. Go forward and be successful. Congratulations.
It gives me great pleasure to certify to the Bergen County Technical School Board of Education that these members of the class of 2023 of Bergen County Technical High School Paramus have successfully completed the requirements for graduation set forth by the Department of Education and have earned this high school diploma on June 26, 2023. I present them to you now for graduation.
And it is with pride and pleasure, as representative, as the president of the Board of Education, that I accept the certification and confirm that these students comprise the Paramus Technical High School of the class of 2023.
I would like to invite Mr. Luke Thawley and Ms. Maria Mijas to come up to the podium to read the class roll. Mr. Wertheim, Dr. Lerner, and Mr. Connolly will now present the diplomas to the graduating class of 2023.
Would the first row please rise? Yahav Becker. David Ethan Longacre. Arturo Josue Alarcón.
This is my guy right here.
Ebony Almanzar. Dante Matthew Anderson. Jason Anning. Gabriel Antigua. Nicole Alexandra Aruma. Jorge Arias. Nikoi O'Neill Beckford. Johan S. Bacotti. Carolina Benitez. Would the first row please be seated? Would the second row please rise? Jared Lucas Berger. Joseph Bernath. Joseph M. Berrios Cucci. Brian Gensi Bascioli. Kayla Rose Brown. Luke S. Brown. Aiden Caceres. Jason Carrillo. Emily Chimera. Christian J. Sinkew. Nicholas V. Sinkew. Kiara Correa. Would the second row please be seated? Would the third row please rise? Jordan Nizer Crane. Stephen Kenneth DeGennaro. April DeGrandi. Valerie Marie Rose D'Onofrio. Carmine Edwards. Peter Biagio Fazzolo. Javier De Leon Ferguson. Olivia Focorino. Brielle Marie Gedrimas. Nicole Catherine Girardelli. Henry Joseph Hahn IV. Would the third row please be seated?
Will the first row please rise? Zayden N. Hillary. Jamae Jackson.
Quinn rules.
Love you, Missy.
Joshua James Jackson. Samaya Kamal. Natalia Kazalka. Justin T. LeBoy. Jaden Robin Luna. Lindsay Louise McKenzie. Anna Rose Marzocca. Matthew Matesik. Rhett S. Matthews. Brendan McGarrigle. Will the first row please be seated? Will the second row please rise? Gilbert D. Mendez. Katie Marie Moran. Zoe Elizabeth Murray. Brian Anthony Ortiz Jr. Ni Afote Otu. Xavier J. Pena. Jonathan Justin Phillips. Brandon Christopher Pollard. Brandon Pola. Meloria May Rogers. Rayshawn Edward Rodriguez. Jade Aleska Rosario. Will the second row please be seated? Will the third row please rise? Jaden Sanchez. Kevin Michael Joseph Shepherd. Gianna Solarzano. Roman William Stabnicki. Morgan Strasser. Ella Suleiman. Anthony Daniel Tortora. Enzo Roberto Verga. Gianna Maria Volsi. Derek George Younglin. Ryan Kirk Youngling. Will the third row please be seated?
At this time, I would like to invite Nicole Giardelli and Gianna Solarzano to come to the stage. Would the class of 2023 please stand? Thank you, senior class officers. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduates of the class of 2023.
In that 12 passenger van in a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name in the star. Now look at where we at, still growing up, still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I've become. Can I wait to get older? Can I wait to be some? Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe.
Wish I didn't think I had the answers. Wish I didn't drink all of that glass first. Wish I made it to homecoming. Got up the courage to ask her. Wish I would've gotten out of my show. Wish I put the bottle back on that shelf. Wish I wouldn't have worried about what other people thought and felt comfortable with myself. Rooftop open and the stars above. Moment frozen, sneaking out and falling in love. Me, you, and that futon. We just begun. On the grass dreaming. Figuring out who I was. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Never thought we'd get old. Maybe we're still young. Maybe you always look back and think it was better than it was. Maybe these are the moments. Maybe I've been missing what it's about. Been scared of the future, thinking about the past while missing out on now. We've come so far, I guess I'm proud. And I ain't worried about the wrinkles around my smile. I got some scars, I've been around. I felt some pain, I've seen some things, but I'm here now. Those good old days.
You don't know what you got till it goes, till it's gone. You don't know what you got till